All right, so I'm on the phone with a customer service. We're updating you on those. But now I'm in the middle of the – I'm trying to disconnect the landline phone. We don't need it anymore. It serves no purpose in our home. And so it's just money that we're flushing, so I want to get rid of it. But now, after, you know, grinding through the waiting, I just want to drop this line. And now I've gotten to the point that if I hang up, everything that I've wasted now has been a waste.
Yeah.
And so, in a very nice person that just spoke very, very plain English, which was a nice upgrade, was just carrying on a conversation. But she's obviously trying to sell me products that I don't want. Okay, and so it now has turned into green eggs and ham. You know, would you like a phone line and a tree? You know, and I'm just like, Sam, let me be. Sam, please let me be. I just want to drop the phone line. Well, I mean, there's a way you could probably keep it and me bundle this and that and this and that and just probably even save you even more money. But I don't want the line. I don't want it anymore. And then finally I threw out because I said, do you know one of the things that it's really more than I just don't use it? I don't like watching TV, you know, with the TV service y'all offer. I don't like the numbers coming across the screen like when there's a big play coming up. You know, that kind of thing. I just don't want it.
Yeah, we should change that, Mr. Burgess.
I just don't. Well, I mean,
let me get you with the next support.
Right. And then this is the one that Sherry said was her favorite. I said I would not be interested in that, and I'm really being very kind.
Yeah.
And then she hears me a minute after a long pause. No, I wouldn't. I would not. No, well, you not interested in that? I am not. Please, Sam, let me be. So finally, this is what Sherry loved. She hurt me. This is when she turned around. She started working on dinner. I said, can I just say something? I just want this to end. I literally said
that.
I said, yeah, I said, I just want this to be over.
Please.
Yeah, that's all I want.
Can I hang up?
I want my line to be disconnected, and I just want this experience to be over. No offense to you, but you know, now I'm doing the Brian Regan bit about the cashiers. I just want to get back to the life I had before this call.
Yeah.
I've got a wife over here working on dinner. I've got a nice afternoon. I said the weather's about to get hotter. It's probably the last day. I mean, yesterday was really good. Now I'm explaining my life to her. And I said, and you know, there was low humidity today. I can feel it coming. I don't have, like, we're thinking about even eating out one more time out there on the screening porch before it's going to be too miserable.
Yeah.
I just want this to be over. And she goes, okay. I said, I just want it to be over.
Please let me cancel.
Yeah, please. It's almost like, I mean, I feel like right now that, you know, I'm Jeremiah Denton. I'm blinking to everybody torture. Yeah. You know, please just, I feel like there's some, I'm almost getting to the point where I'm like, am I trapped in this? I mean, is there no way out of this? And I got to tell you, because my personality, at least four times, just forget it, rose up.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but the other side of me, the other Rick, that says, no, we're going to finish this. Mm-hmm. If you get off this phone call and this is not finished, you realize the time that you put into this is over.
Yeah.
And you
got to get something out of it.
The two me's are going, there's that lackadaisical, apathetic me that's like, just forget it.
Yeah.
And then, you know, the fun's on me. And then there's the real serious, let's get things done me going, I tell you, don't listen to him.
Right.
If we'll lose this time, Rick, and we'll never have, can you live the rest of your day knowing you did nothing in this time? You've accomplished nothing. You finish this! Like, I look, the other me's not even listening now because he's left.
Yeah.
You know,
on the back deck. He's like,
are the stuff on the screen that bad? Maybe we'll use it one day, Rick. And I just,
you may need it.
So then it became honestly a competition. Now I've gone from maybe being open to maybe being open to keeping the line to now I feel like I lose if I end up with the line. I must win this. Yeah. I must have this line disconnected. I'm not even caring anymore. The packages she's presenting, I'm not even hearing the numbers anymore. Mm-hmm. At one time, it got like an airplane when they oversell them.
Yeah.
And before you know it, they're offering outrageous American Express cards. 5,000! You know, at one point, she's like, how about no charge? No! Drop that line! If you keep
we'll
the line,
we'll pay you to keep it.
How about we give you 10 bucks to keep it? Never! You know, it's like we became in a competition. Yeah. It's like she's like, want to tell her boss I kept the line. I'm wanting to tell Sherry they canceled it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's over now.
Yeah.
And it became a battle. But I really got just pitiful at one point. I just, that's literally how I said it.
You were begging. You were begging for mercy.
I just want this to be over.
Please let me in.
It's no more complicated than where we began. I do not like landlines and ham. I do not want them, Sam. I am okay.
Let me be.
I don't want it on a train. I don't want it with a fox. I don't want it
on a box.
In a box. I don't want it here or there. I don't want it anywhere. Please drop my phone. Please. I'm now begging a company. As if I have no say in it.
Yeah, I know.
Please
stop talking.
Please, I'm begging you. I just want this to be over. I've been involved in this phone call now for 50 minutes.
What?
And I just, not, I'm talking about the whole time, from the time I started.
Yeah.
I just want it to be over. And when I said that, I even started walking down the steps to go out and mess with the dog. I got to change the scenery here.
Yeah.
At one point, I'm out in the yard now. She can hear birds chirping. I just want this to be over. I can't believe you and I are still on the phone. We don't even know each other. Yeah. I didn't talk to my mother this long.
I don't know. Not even close.
Okay. I wrap up family before now. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Please drop my landline phone.
Yeah. That's all I want.
Well, I mean, I just can't believe you're willing to pay more to get rid of it. I mean, you're going to save some, but I mean, if you just keep it, I think I can even save more. I don't want to
save more.
I mean, now I'm getting emotional.
Right. Yeah.
Please. Yeah. I just don't even want it. Please don't make me have this landline. It's almost like the landline was this rude guest. I couldn't get to leave.
Yeah.
I'm just like, why is this difficult? I don't even understand why this is difficult. I mean, the landline is archaic. It's like this grumpy old man. It's like, well, I'm not leaving here. You know, and I'm like, please, why are y'all clinging to these landlines?
So she finally gave in?
Oh, yeah. At one point, she's asking about my TV viewing habits.
Oh, my goodness. Good there.
I don't like discussing my habits with anybody.
You know what I told her? I said the only live event we even watch is if there's news breaking or there's a sporting event. Everything else we watch on streaming. What kind of streaming?
There we go.
Would you just drop the line? So finally, at the end, by the way, she's from Michigan. Found that out.
Okay. Hey, a new friend.
Finally, got her address for Christmas. finally, they dropped it. I have no
idea.
Sure?
Have you checked?
At one point, I may be paying double now. I just wanted it to be over.
Yeah.
I don't even know what I agreed to. I just wanted it to be over.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.